Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create test plan using OpenAI. If you are preparing test plan for any of your projects, why to waste time creating manually? ChatGPT or OpenAI will help you quickly create your test plan. I'm not saying you can always be dependent on the ChatGPT, but if we are getting flexibility to create and modify and use it to our requirements, why not to use it? To avoid wasting lot of time and effort from your bucket, make sure to create or prepare draft plan with the help of ChatGPT and post that, make it according to your requirement. Here, I will show you end-to-end process how we can build test plan with the help of OpenAI. To start with this, first I will log in into my ChatGPT account, and from here just write it down your test plan. Right away, simply you can write create a test plan for me. Create a test plan for me. So this will give you a detailed background how we can build it. Because we have not defined anything usual, you can see here it's showing like test plan, which means it's introductions, test items. What all test items will be included, like descriptions of the software and products being tested, components or modules included in the testing, features to be added. So it means list of features to be included or not, features not to be tested. It means out of scope value. Next is testing approach, testing techniques to be used like black box or white box testing, testing methodologies if we are going ahead with the agile or waterfall model, test environment setup. Are we using UAT, QA or development environment? Based on that, it will build it. Test schedules. It will give us the timeline of each of the phases of the testing, like planning, executions, reporting, and finally milestone and deadline. Test cases, which all test cases to be included, covering all aspects of the software, including features, corner cases, positive and negative test cases. Test case idea, disk system, steps, expected results, actual results, and status. These all are the attributes of test cases. Which all test data required? Sources of the test data, are we taking out from the database or we are getting from the end user or from the business team? Which all testing tools will be needed? Are we going to go ahead with the manual as well as automation? Purpose of each tool, configurations and setup instructions, risk and mitigation strategy. So this will give you a complete idea how we can build it. It's giving us the complete flexibility. Just copy and paste it and modify it according to your need. Next, here we have not defined anything, which type of applications I wanted to test. That's the reason it's giving me a detailed outline how and what we can include inside our test plan. But if we are just giving an input to the OpenAI, OpenAI will give you a more cleared way how you can create a test plan. This time, let's consider I wanted to build a test plan, create test plan for e-commerce website, and feature includes shopping items, cart, gift card, profile page, and login, logout section. Hit enter. Now, when we'll enter the input or when we'll provide the input related to the technologies or related to the applications, what we are going to test or for what we are building test plan, you will see here. This will give you a descriptive way where it will define the purpose. So this test plan outlines the testing approach, objectives and delivery for testing on e-commerce website, which is good. Scope, the testing will focus on shopping items, cart functionality, gift card features, profile pages and login logout sections. It means whatever input or functionality I define, it will include everything. Objectives are ensuring the functionality, usability, security and performance of the e-commerce website. Next is assumption. So we are also adding the assumptions like controlled environment with the access of necessary resources. These are the assumptions. If it is not there, it means we have to highlight it. Next will be potential risk, including security and vulnerabilities. Test items. So these are the test items. It means it's divided between functionality to functionality. The e-commerce website under test, shopping items features, cart functionalities, gift and features, profile page, login and logout section. Features to be tested. These are the features: product browsing, product search, product details. Then cart will also have some descriptive items. Gift card will have again few of the items added. Profile pages, it means viewing and editing user informations, order history, login and logout. Exactly same way when we are using Amazon, Walmart or Flipkart, you can see we have options to edit and modify our profile. Similarly, here also you can see user authentications and session management. Why it is required? Let's say you have logged in and you have kept this website idle for several hours. It means if we have added session management, it will automatically pop up a message to log out. It will be not accessed by any external user. So that's the reason. Testing approach makes combination of black box and gray box testing. It's a suggestions from the ChatGPT. But if you want, you can include your own methodologies or techniques. Agile testing methodologies, because this application is big enough, that's the reason it suggested the best approach. But if you want to go ahead with some other methodologies, you can also select it. Here, ChatGPT is suggesting the best approach to use it, but it's not at all mandatory. You can use the same approach. You can also go ahead with some other methodologies or techniques or environment. Next is testing deliveries, test plan documents, the item, test cases, test executions report and defect reports. What is the test schedule times? Here you have to modify it. Planning phase, how much time it will take for the planning phase, which involves your documentations, test case preparations or environment related setup, as well as your environment readiness. Next will be execution phases, how much time it will take for the executions, and reporting, where you are sharing the regular report. And finally, test executions report and defect reports will be a major part here. Test cases. In test cases, it has given just some right way, but if you want, even you can elaborate it more. Test data. So these are the test data, testing tools. It's suggested according to his knowledge or experience based on this applications, but it's not at all mandatory you can use it. Risk and mitigations are also highlighted, where security is a major risk here because transactions related informations are involved. Here we are using internal or users transactions related data. So security is must here. Risk, performance issues, if there are a lot of products are uploaded at the same time, or if there is a lot of traffic reach to this website, then also there will be risk that should be handled. Defect reporting is a defect reporting using the designated tools, severity and priority classifications, as well as escalations procedure for fixing those defects. Testing reports are general processes. If you want, you can use it Excel, or if you are using some test kit management tool, you can always use that reporting. Approvals and sign off is the basic process. Once the sign off is done, this product will move into the production. Now, if any point of time you want to elaborate it more, just write here more inputs on this. Now, if you can see, this has highlighted 3 or 5 different modules like risk, mitigations, like encrypting sensitive data such as user password, payment and all, then performance issues under heavy load, then payment processing failures, if there is, so that tracking needs to be taken care of, and compatibility issues across devices and browser. This application should be accessible from different or all the browsers. Otherwise, it will be a challenge for the users, or it will be a blocker for the user, because we cannot say that user can use it either Google Chrome or Firefox or in Internet Explorer or Edge. So in this scenario, this mitigations will be required. Here, if you want, even you can elaborate more on other verticals like testing tools, test reporting, approval cycles, appendixes if we have. These all are factors which we can include it while preparing test plan. Important tips. When we are using AI-based tools, I would not say to rely 100% on it, because this AI tool is generating any informations based on the algorithm or based on the input it was fed inside the system. Yes, you can use this tool, but make sure to read out each and every components, and wherever is required the modifications, try to do it. Otherwise, it might be a blunder for you. That's the reason it's always suggested to take a help of AI, but use your own mind as well. Here, it will minimize your effort of preparing all those aspects manually. Better to use it, but not 100%. It means you can take an ideas, get input from this, and paste it there, modify it according to your application, according to your products. So that's it from today's video. Hope you enjoyed the thing. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. And if you wanted to learn more on software testing or OpenAI, feel free to add the topic name in comment sections. I will be happy to add more video on this based on demand. Thank you for watching.